I'm going to start with reverse knee stretches. Reverse knee stretches are one of my favorite exercises in terms of scapular connection and ab connection. So for this though, the spring is super light. You're going to go to just one blue spring. And then you're going to kneel this way, knees up against the shoulder rest. My hands are on the outside of the reformer. So here, I'm gonna take a breath in. I'm exercising two versions, round back and flat back. The round back, I'm gonna exhale, picking up the belly, just like the regular knee stretch, pull the carriage in. I'm sitting towards my heels, and I'm gonna reverse that motion back down. Right, so exhaling and inhaling. And so people go wrong in a lot of ways. They pull with their arms, right, very different motion. They grab strongly here. I could actually do this exercise with my hands just on the side of the reformer. I don't even need weight on my hands. So the work is really the scapula pulling down, the belly pulling in. So that's the round back. The flat back, I'm gonna try and hold neutral. It feels very much like just a hinge, doggy hinge, right? Hips down, up, hips down, up, hips down, up. So just holding stable. Then we have the oblique version, both hands on one side, rounding coming in, and reverse. This one's really nice, cross body, and in, exhale, and in. And then I would switch to the other side. Same thing, connecting and down. So work is all on the lower half. Upper half's work is just to stabilize, shoulder blades down. It feels really nice. It's great work for the abs. Great work for shoulder stabilization and connecting your deep abdominals to the scapula shoulder region. So again, that lat side body connection. Next big series, and this is stomach massage series. This series is a classic series. I can't say that I use it all that much because I just don't love the load. It's very loaded in flexion on this one, but it is a super classic and a kind of a precursor to getting strong for abdominal exercises. It does put some good things together. On the first version, which is the round back version, I have two reds and a blue spring on. My foot bar is gonna be in the low position for this entire series. And if you have a slippery pants on, putting a sticky pad on the edge is actually a really good idea. So here my hands relax in front of the reformer. I'm gonna take a breath in and press backwards. And I'm gonna imagine that somebody's putting their foot in my stomach here. So I'm gonna press back, hollowing. Heels go down, heels go up, and I work my way back in. Right, so exhale, heels down, heels up, and bend back in. That is the classic original version. Then I'm gonna drop one, I'm gonna drop the blue spring off for my flat back version. So flat back version, I take my arms back here. It's going to help me open my chest and open my chest, my back. And then I'm going to press out. Heels go down. Heels go up. And I'm coming in, but I'm keeping flat back now. Now this version I actually really like. It opens the shoulders, opens the chest, opens the back. Right, and it could be safe for somebody with a back injury as long as they're staying in neutral spine the whole time, right? So then I'm gonna go to the variations. The variations, I'm not gonna do the heel drop anymore. I'm just gonna hold to, so bouquet is the first one, and all I'm gonna do is press open and close. Other side, open and close. Open and close, open, and close. And then I have spider fingers where I'm just taking my fingertips here. I'm trying to open into flat back with just fingertips here. Good. Pressing back, right? And pressing back. And the final variation is reaching. Here I'm gonna take my arms overhead. I'm gonna press and bend. Press and bend. Yeah, this one we say pulls your pants down. If your pants are falling down in the back, that's the right thing. You don't wanna just press out and in, right? Very different. I'm pressing underneath, reaching forward and up, yeah?